So this is LIBLADE. I did a review on this one already, a little test on it, and I've been playing it and I've been steadily leveling up because I got to the last part of the game and it was giving me stupid trouble. So this is just more gameplay of the game. I'm going to be leveling up. I'm at level 174. I'm not going and trying to fight that last boss or make it through the I can't make it through the last stage until I'm like, I don't know, man. Maybe 300. So this is just gonna be some gameplay of me going through the first and second stages, leveling up. This is a good game too. Remember the I play so many games. I play a lot of games, but not often at the same time. And so I kind of forget all the little perks. All right. So right here you can choose what area you want to go in. I usually just go through two and three, again just to level up. It's a short game, but the gameplay loop is fun. It's like you hack and slash, you hack and slash, you get to a boss. If you can't get through, get to get if you can't beat them, you can come back and level up and then try again. It's that kind of Borderlands loop that got me hooked. I ended up playing this game. When I first saw it in an indie event, in Japan. It was an indie event. It was actually, I'm gonna try to get my game into that because when I saw that. But yeah, I saw this game. I'm like, huh, this looks kind of fun, you know. And I thought that actually played really unique. You move with the analog, so it's not like button mashing. Oh, technically it's still a button. It's not a face button, but yeah, so it's actually pretty fun and pretty cool. And again, it's another one of those games proven that you don't have to have over the top realistic looking graphics or a lot of things going on for the game to be fun. So like, as a developer, don't get stuck in that trap of thinking you have to have like high fidelity and be using all the power of the system and all that. Unless the game absolutely calls for it, you know. And then he sits down way too fast. Like, he sits down way too fast. Like, he's just been asleep for ages. Seen all the numbers all over the place. I'm like, okay, what is this? That's how you know it's kind of like a lot gonna be going on. You got numbers all over the place. A lot of stuff blowing up. Yeah. like everything is all over the place, but you have to use his ability. That's for sure. Do I have all of these? In a game like this, could he use a second character? You know, speaking of graphics, I wouldn't mind seeing a game that plays like this, but with some like more realistic looking characters that I can do. I didn't notice the indicator showing you when your health is low too. That's pretty cool. I'm legit not stopping until I'm like 300, man, I promise.
in it.
So yeah, this is just some more LIBLADE gameplay. Like I said, I got one more stage I'm trying to beat, but I died several times. It's like I said, I'm not going to try to tackle it until I'm like level 300. So I'm going to do a video of that once I finally get there to that point. And then I'm going to tackle the boss and let y'all see the very end of it. Because he fights this other character that's like himself. So I'm curious to see if he comes back, because you don't defeat him, they kind of like phase off. So we'll see. I got a feeling he's probably going to come back and help him or something. But yeah, that's some more LIBLADE. Check this game out. It's on Steam. I think it's like $20. It was on sale during the indie Japanese event. So check this out. LIBLADE. Really good game.